This is the, we talk about the digital signature. Again, the digital certificate, okay? If you buy any software, they all has what? They all has something called digital certificate. If you buy a copy, the digital certificate will not be verified. So the digital certificate is actually a certificate approve the original of the message or the original of the software. So when Microsoft sell Windows, it sell with a digital certificate. So when you install Windows in your computer, if it's a copy, it will show you in the corner that it is a copy, not original Windows. Okay, because why? Because the digital certificate attached to that is changed. Someone copy it, okay? And this is the same for every software. And the same concept applied when you try to communicate with your friend. So we have something called what? Digital certificate. This digital certificate will be attached to the message for the security purpose, okay? Now, the digital certificate is used commonly for what? To verify what? This is the in this color. I'm gonna underline it. To verify that the user sending a message is who or she claimed to be. This is the main job of the digital certificate, okay? So when I receive the message, I check the digital certificate. If it's correct, then the sender is the one, the correct one. If it's not, then in this case, we have to say that there's someone in the middle trying to fake things up. All right, now, of course, when you send a message, either using WhatsApp or any email or anything like that, you want to encrypt your message, okay? So this encrypted message, you will apply with it a digital certificate. Where we get the digital certificate? There is a place called what? CA. What do you call it? Certificate Authority. Okay, when you have your birth certificate, where do you get your birth certificate? Okay, from the civil department. Okay, this is the only place that you get civil our birth certificate. Same thing with the digital certificate. You get it from a place called what? Certificate Authority. Certificate Authority. Not anyone can give you a certificate. This is not the way it happened, right? So this is the authority that used to generate a digital certificate. Now the CA or the certificate authority issue a digital certificate, and not just a digital certificate, it's encrypted one. It is encrypted one. Now, what does this contain? It is contained two things, okay? It's contained public key is the main component, and what? Identification information. Identification information could be a lot more than one information or more than one information, such as the device MAC address, or if you send it using the WhatsApp, your WhatsApp account identification ID, you have an ID number or username or in the system, or anything that identify the user, a correct user. So the CA issue what? Issue a digital certificate, and this digital certificate is encrypted, actually. Encrypted digital certificate, okay? And this digital certificate contains the public key and ID information. And ID information. Great. So when you receive a message, what you should do, okay, you should contact the certificate authority, okay, to get the public key and decrypt the certificate, okay? When you decrypt the certificate, you can see that who sent you the message, and what is his public key, or what is his identification, username, or any identification information that could be there. Okay, so this is the things. I have to contact both the sender and receiver, need to contact CA. The sender need to contact CA in order to get digital certificate, and he store it there, right? If you are the receiver, need to contact the CA in order to decrypt the digital certificate and verify the person, all right? Now, digital certificate, again, it's more like a password, okay? It's more like the password that help the receiver or people to what? To exchange what? Information over the internet, okay? And they use what? PKI, or what do you call it? Public key infrastructure. We already saw sample digital certificate on the cryptos. So if you have a public key in the cryptos, you can show the digital certificate from there. So the digital certificate sometimes is known as a public key, or it's called identity certificate. So it has different names. So for example, here, if I go to see the keys, okay, display the keys, and if I display this one, I could say show certificate. If you show certificate, this is the information in the certificate. What's the version of certificate? Who is the owner of the certificate? The person who claimed to be, his name and his ID, okay? And also, you can see that who issued this certificate, issued by the crypto CA, which is a certificate authority actually, all right? And you can see that, what is the serial number of the certificate? And it is valid for what? Until 2021, November 29. Okay, it's valid for 1 year. So if you receive a message for a certificate and it is expired, that means it's a fake, right? They're attached also something for the public key. So you can use it to what? To decrypt any information from this user. And this is the certificate itself here. This is the certificate. And you get some other information, which function they are using, SHA-1 for the, and this is the signature. This is the signature of the person. And you can see that which algorithm they use for the signature. They use MD5 and they use SHA-1. So this is the digital certificate. And also, there's one thing that I want to show that you might, something is interesting. So if you open any website, so I say www.google.com. All right. Now, also, the website has a digital certificate, okay? It's important that you know how to get that. I have to go and click in the menu and go to where? Where we go? More tools. More tools. And we go where? To the developer tool. If you go to the developer tools, that will give you a lot of options. Okay? And one of these options is the code of the page and the page itself and even the HTML that used in there. And if there's something that you can use, they can use as well. But I'm not concerned about the code. I'm gonna go to the what? To the security tab here. To the security tab. And I click on the security tab. In the security tab, you can see certificate here. And it say valid and trusted. If you want to view the certificate, you can view the certificate and you can say click on it. When you click on a view certificate, you will get all the information about the certificate. All the information about the certificate. So you can see what? You can see that, that This is issued to Google. Issued by who? By Google TASCA. There's always a letter CA, Certificate Authority. And it's valid until 26/1/2021. So every year they need to validate their security. You can go into more details here. Okay, and you can see the version is version 3. The serial number is here. If I give you a question in the exam, what's the serial number? You can click on it and copy it and paste it in the answer. Okay, and there's also, what is the signature algorithm? The signature algorithm is SHA-256-RSA. What is the signature hash algorithm? SHA-256. And who's the issuer? The issuer is Google Trust Service, CA. And it's in the USA. And you can say it's valid by time and day and hour until expired with time. And there's a lot of things here. You can see what's the public key. This is the public key. You can use it to encrypt something for it. Okay. And you can see here that the public key is, how long is it? 256 bit. And you can see also a lot of things, identifier, authority key, a lot of information. And you can see even the policy. The policy is a document or guidelines. And you can see a lot of information about this certificate. So the certificate is not just a name, it contains a lot of information that identify the user. Okay, key management, okay? We talked about this before. Now, we said we have two things that need to care about. Is one of these things is what? Key distribution. Okay, so the digital signature problem is solved, but the key distribution is not solved. That's the main issue. Okay, so we need to think about how to distribute the key. Okay, and how we will use the public key to distribute secret key. All right. Now, what we said before, we have a secret key. Okay, we need to use the public key to encrypt this secret key and send it, encrypt it. How do we use that? Okay, that's good. We encrypt the secret key with the public key, but how we deliver it to the other person? How do we use the keys? We need to understand we have four ways to distribute the key. We need to understand each one. So when we get to compare between them, we know exactly how they work. The first one is called public announcement. From the name, it is what? It is public announcement. All right. So for example, you can use what? You can use the RSA. Okay. And there's some weakness, yes, okay, but you can use it. And public announcement, you can publish your key. When you say key, you say public key. You can publish your key on a website, for example, on your website. This is my key, okay? Or in the directory, like the phone directory, okay? So if you want to send me a message, this is my key. Please use it. So this is the first one. It's a public announcement by using what? On the public key. So the public key is public. Okay, everyone should know it. There's no harm of knowing it. Good. Second one is a little bit different. Okay, it's a public available directory. Not a public announcement for everyone, but it should be what? In a public available directory, okay? And this directory contain public keys for the people. So what I do, I put my public key inside this directory. This directory is more like a contact list, okay? Like when you want to call someone, you go on your mobile like this, okay? And you try to find where's the number of the person, and then you click on it. So the same thing here on the public directory, okay? I put my key in the directory. So when anyone wants to send me, he can search me, and he got my key, and he can send me, encrypt the information using my key. So it's not public. It is only in a specific place that if anyone need me, he can search me, okay? Now this public directory, okay, could be managed by what? By a trusted organization or trusted party. For example, your mobile number, okay? If your mobile number, you publish it online, like public announcement, everyone will see your mobile, okay? So you publish it anywhere, in your directory, or on your website, or in some Instagram, or in Facebook, or on Twitter. Oh, this is my number. It's a public announcement, okay? But if you say it's a public available directory, then your Omantel, okay, let's say Omantel, for example, is the person who managed the directory. So your number is saved on the directory that managed by Omantel, okay? Not everyone can see it. Only the person that you want him to see, or he can see this directory, all right? So it's a public, but it's not public as you think, okay? It's public only on a private way. This is how when we say that, because this directory is managed by what? By Omantel, a company, and you trust this company for not sharing your mobile with everyone. That's what we call it, a trusted third party or organization, okay? The third way is called public key authority, okay? When we say public key authority, we're talking about an authority that saves the public key, actually. It's not a directory, it is an authority, okay? And there's a difference between them. So each one will have a public key, okay? And this public key will be known to what? To the public key authority. So this is the public key authority, okay? And you know the public key for it. So it's considered as a person, okay? It has a public key. And you have a public key. Your public key is saved where? Here. Okay? Your public key is saved here. So, if I want to send someone a message, I need to get his public key. Which place I contact? I contact the public key authority. I send a request to the public key authority that I want the public key for someone. Okay, I want the public key for B. The request say, I need the public key for B. B public key. Can you send it to me? Okay. Now, what happened in the public key authority, if you are registered, they will send you the key. But if you are not registered, they will not send you the key. How they send you the key? They take B key and encrypt it using what? Using what? Using their private key. using their private key. They have a private key. They will encrypt it using the private key. Say they will encrypt using the private key your request and the public key of B. So you receive the message. You have to decrypt the message. How do you decrypt the message? Using what? Using the public key for the authority, because you know the public key for the authority. And you decrypt the message. Okay, so when you decrypt the message, you encrypt your own message and send it directly to what? To B. Now B, in order to communicate with you, he need to decrypt the message that received from you. Okay, so again, he need to contact what? The public key authority. I need the public key for what? For A. And that will encrypt it with the private key for the authority and the public key for A. And then you can use it for what? You can use it to decrypt the message. Is that clear? It's kind of someone, a place that all public key is stored there. And if you ask him about send me the public key, they will encrypt this key using their private key. They have a private key and send it to you. And they assume that you know their public key, so to know the things, okay? So it's more organized way, but it's still not secure. Because if anyone can ask the public key authority to give me the key for anyone. So it's still organized way, and that's good. Better than the directory. Why better than the directory? Because there's encryption here. There's some encryption here, and the information is encrypted, actually, which is secure, better than the directory. But it's still something not right, because everyone can ask for other one directory, and if he knows the public key for the public authority, he can ask for the key for anyone. And we do want that, okay? We want it more organized and more secure. This is why we have the last one, which is called... Well, now this is all about, this is the scenario I explained. It's an explanation for this diagram. Now, okay, good, all right. This is the C, this is about C. So B, and this is the original request, the original timestamp, and all these things. This is still explanation about the, now the message, if you send the message to the public authority, that will include or receive a message that will include the public key for Bob and also the message that you want to send and the original request. It is already explained here. When they send it back to you, you extend the public key for Bob, the request that you already sent before, and the time for the response and your message. The last one is called public key certificate. The public key certificate, okay, it uses digital certificate, and which is more secure than what? More secure than the previous one. So basically, it is a digitally signed document that serves to validate the sender authority and name. More like a digital certificate, okay? So the document will contain what? Like this. First of all, we contain the name of the person who holds this certificate. This is the name. And then after that, it will contain the public key of that person. And then the last thing, what? The digital signature. Digital signature for who? Okay, for the CA. Digital signature for the CA. So there is no three component, okay, that should be included in the document. That's document, the certificate, digitally signed document. These things should be included. Certificate holder name, his public key, and the digital signature for the CA. Digital signature for the CA, okay? Now, what happened is that, okay, is that when it comes to the public key certificate, it attests that the sender name is one associated with the public key. Make sure that the sender name is actually the same person in the signed or associated public key document, okay? So yeah, every person there have a unique ID to separate them from each other. All right, one more things about the public key infrastructure. So this is a more organized way, okay? So we have four ways to distribute the keys: public announcement, public available directory, public key authority, and public key certificate. Public key certificate is more like a public key authority, okay? There's someone in the middle, but it's not just encryption with the public key. There's a digital certificate signed document, digital signature or digital signed document instead of the encryption, in addition to the encryption as well. Why is that? Because I have your signature, served with me. When you send me a request, I can verify that you are the person who's sending me the request, not someone else. Okay? This is, fix the bugs in the public key authority where anyone can claim that I am Dr. Munder, I want the public key for Safa Muhammad. Okay? So everyone can claim that, but instead of that, they say, okay, you have to send me your digital signed document. When you send it, I have your signature. I can verify is that you are Safa or not. Okay, you got it? The last thing, there's a few things about public key infrastructure. Public key infrastructure is basically more like a framework. Okay, this framework is used for two things. Used for identification. Used for identification. This is the first thing, and distribution, key distribution. So it's a framework used for identification and key distribution. Identification through what? Through digital signature and digital certificate, and key distribution using the four techniques that we mentioned before, okay? Of course, it should have what? It should have some policies and guidelines and procedure, okay? So it should have, it's to provide a set of procedure and policy. Why we need to provide a set of procedure and policy? For the same reason that we all want, is what? Security. Make sure that our channel is secure and no one is changing anything in there, okay? So they can exchange data over the internet. The internet is unsecure, okay? So they can exchange data over the internet and rely that, and no one will be able to see that data, and I can verify the identity of my friend if he sent me a message. This is why we have a set of policy in order to secure the communication between two parties. Now, also, PKI is a standard technology to improve the security policy, okay? To improve your security policy of all the protocols, such as TCP, IP, so it's added there, okay? So when you add the PKI to all the protocols, you make sure that the security is improved and you trust that person. So these things, to what? To facilitate confidence and trust between the people who will exchange the message. The last thing that I need to know is that this framework, okay, has some service security or security service. These security services include what? Authentication, integrity, confidentiality, and on obligation. Non-obligation. So So remember these three. This framework provides security services such as authentication, integrity, confidentiality, and non-repudiation. And that's the end of the today lecture. So we talk about a few things that you need to remember the difference between them. We talk about what is the public key and how we distribute the key. We talk about some of the message authentication mechanisms such as MAC and hash function. We talk about what is the digital signature and what is the digital certificate. And we show you and demonstrate for you how you can view the digital certificate for a person from his digital signature, public signature, public key, or you can view the digital certificate for a website, for example.